Welcome to the Smoke Learning channel. Continuing on from the introduction of the Alpha channel, let's look at ways to import images into Autodesk Smoke that have associated Alpha channels. For all imports, you can use the Media Hub. Using the file browser, I have browsed to a folder containing a file with an embedded Alpha. You can see at the bottom right corner of the clip that there is a multi-tag. This is your indication that there is more channels embedded in the file alongside the RGB color channel. If you double-click on the multi-tag, the file browser will expand the clip and expose the embedded channels. Here you can see the RGB color channel and the Alpha transparency channel. Typically, when Smoke imports media with a variety of channels, it will always create a separate clip for the color channel and another clip for the Alpha transparency channel. This is by design. You can import the channels as separate clips, but most of the time you probably don't need to. Double-click on the multi-tag to collapse the clip. Under the General tab, there is an option called Create Matte Container. This option is on by default, and when you drag the source with an embedded Alpha into the media library, Smoke will create one multi-channel container clip containing the RGB clip and the Alpha clip. This means you will always have the correct information together for keying and compositing from a specific source clip. Another scenario that can happen is if you are given separate files for the color channels and separate files for the Alpha channel. So in the file browser, here is a typical example. You can clearly see which clip contains the RGB channel and which clip contains the respective Alpha transparency channel. Now, since they are two separate files, the Create Matte Container function will not do anything as it is designed for multi-channel files like in the previous example. In this case, you have to drag them in as separate clips into the media library. This is actually what you would have got if you had turned off Create Matte Container in the previous example. Now, this is not a problem. In the context of compositing, you could work with the separate clips, and for certain tasks, Smoke will create the matte container for you. However, if you just want to keep things together, you can still create a matte container after you have imported in your clips. To do this, access your desktop tools, choose the Utilities tab, and you can click Create Matte Container. Just drawing your attention to the options on the right of the screen. The expected inputs is the front clip followed by the matte clip. In other words, you will first select the clip with the RGB color channels and then select the clip containing the Alpha channel. The matte container parameter tells us what is going to happen. For this instance, this operation is only going to place the RGB clip and the Alpha clip into a matte container clip. Let's select the RGB or front clip first. The cursor will update on the first click. Now click the clip with the Alpha channel. The cursor will change once more. With this final cursor, tap down on the desktop and the container clip will be created. Since both clips are stored in the matte container, you can delete the originals by either dragging them down to the bottom of the screen or by selecting them and pressing the delete button. The choice is yours, but I'll keep them for the next video. So you have seen how to import files with Alpha channels and make container clips containing RGB and Alpha. Next up, we'll look at how to key these containers over a background in a sequence. Thank you for watching, and please subscribe to the Smoke Learning channel for future videos.